This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
We're road tripping tonight to rediscover a forgotten South Shore highway.
When this was the main road to the Cape, traffic would be stopped here.
People still stop for a beer and a bucket of balls.
It's truly unique.
To catch a glimpse of the legendary Yellow Man and his yellow house.
Yellow is happiness sunshine. Show a brighter light.
An untamed landscape for hiking. Must-have sandwiches for lunch. And a break for physical fine-tuning.
And now you're gonna fly up in the air, okay? Get those legs nice and straight.
This jam-packed highway even has its own beverage.
And named aptly for Route 53, where we're located.
Riding Route 53, next on Chronicle.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight, discover Route 53 for the very first time or see what's changed since the old days.
We'll take our time stopping to get a bit of exercise, a bite of food, or at our first destination, both food and exercise.
Stretching 22 miles between Quincy and Kingston, Route 53 is best known as the old road to Cape Cod. Today, it's an intriguing mix of old and new. What's new? The revitalization of Weymouth Landing. Split between Braintree and Weymouth, a variety of businesses call the Landing home. In development, commercial and residential buildings, attracting millennials to the neighborhood. What's old is the Hanover Mall, to be replaced by Hanover Crossing, an open-air shopping center. Both old and new, this driving range meets restaurant complex.
My partner Jim Bristol, the landlord here, had the existing driving range and always wanted to come up with something.
So Will O'Connell and his team brought the Range Bar and Grill to the Weathervane Golf Academy.
The families, the working professionals we get, people want to incorporate the driving range aspect into their dining experience. And that's the magical part of this.
Customers are often seen lounging on the AstroTurf, enjoying live entertainment on the weekends.
Like Sunday morning.
At night, you know, when the music starts, sometimes you tend to get that younger crowd in here, which is also good. So we are different. You know, we have everybody can come here and have a nice time, have something good to eat and a good drink.
The Range offers a seasonal menu, but favorites are available year-round.
The burrata is one of my most popular appetizers. We do a nice burrata cheese and has a homemade pesto on there. We also do a Cobb salad, which is definitely our most popular salad that we have. It has a little bit of Cajun chicken, avocado, egg. And then another item is our steak frites, which is gluten-free, which is another reason why it's probably so popular, served with a truffle fry and a mixed green.
During cooler months, Range bartenders are mixing up pumpkin martinis and apple cider sangrias. But the Route 53 is a hit any time of year.
It's freshly squeezed grapefruit juice. We do a deep 80 ruby red vodka, simple syrup, and we do a Saint Germain liqueur. It's an elderflower liqueur. It's super refreshing, and even though it doesn't seem as seasonal for the winter time and fall months, we do keep it. It's one of the most popular drinks that we make and named aptly for Route 53, where we're located.
O'Connell jumped at the opportunity to partner with the Weymouth Brewery, Barrel House Z.
I'm a true restaurant operator, owner that does care about the community. And when I found out that Barrel House Z was gonna be a neighbor, literally a mile and a half away, I decided to give them two tap lines. And it also helps when their product is so good. That is by far our most popular beer on tap.
Bill Murphy is the Academy's head golf professional.
Once the sun goes down, we put on the big spotlights and you can hit all night long for the most part. They're always serving nice cold beverages.
A lot of our competition has outside seating, but you can hit a bucket of balls, have a bucket of beers. It's truly unique.
Route 53 has been traveled for nearly 400 years. Part of it was once known as Queen Anne's Turnpike, and
this, Queen Anne's Corner, named after a successful tavern owner from the 1700s. But Anne was no queen. Though she lived with a man and had three children, she never married. Quite a scandal back in those days, and it earned her the old English nickname, Queen, meaning woman of ill repute.
In Pembroke, turn off busy 53 and discover serenity. Willow Brook Farm, a Wildlands Trust property.
The Wildlands Trust is the regional land trust for southeastern Massachusetts.
Wildlands Trust President Karen Gray manages about 250 properties in 40 Massachusetts towns. Willow Brook Farm is one of the trust's most popular properties.
You'll notice that the trails we have here are pretty wide compared to a lot of other conservation lands. People like wider trails because you have less chance of picking up ticks along the way. You'll see we have a lot of benches. There are places for people to have picnics.
These 129 acres were owned by Native Americans until the 1600s when they became farmland. Wildlands Trust purchased the property in 1998. Visitors can enjoy a leisurely stroll or get their heart rates going on roughly 2.5 miles of trail.
There are about 110 different bird species. This place is full of deer, all different kinds of small mammals. There have been over 500 different plants cataloged on this one property.
On our walk, we noticed something quite unusual.
We have these enormous ant mounds. They're called Allegheny ant mounds. They're really striking. They almost look like rocks that are in the ground, and they're these huge nesting areas, this habitat for this particular species of ants.
Willow Brook Farm is open to the public, and dogs are allowed. Gray encourages people to get out and visit not just for fresh air, but because conservation land is important.
We preserve pieces of open space because it's part of the heritage of the community. We preserve them because it protects water supply, it protects habitats for wildlife, scenic values that people care about. And what a property like this offers is just the ability to get away from everything. You get physical exercise, but it's also an opportunity to just get away from Route 53. Sorry.
All right, and back to Range Bar and Grill. They have a covered hitting area where golfers can practice their swing all year round.
Right, which they may need, actually, for part of this weekend as well. They also have outdoor dining, which might be nice for another part of this weekend, because part of the weekend is going to be nice. But even when they have inclement weather, they can still do stuff outside because they've got heat lamps and a fireplace. You might have seen that in the video. So they're sort of ready for all types of weather, and that's what we're going to have this weekend. So if you go, they'll be ready for you.
It's perfect. All right, for a family business in Duxbury, Fridays were golden opportunities.
When traffic was jammed on the way to the Cape, Bongies made highway deliveries.
My mother and her brother, they provide them with box lunches.